A very good afternoon, Anna. Thanks for tuning into the midday news on Rajya Sabha television. Well, biggest developing news stories at the top of this hour coming up in the next 30 minutes. First up, the headlines. Ajay Bharat, Atal BJP. Prime Minister Modi gives slogan for upcoming polls in four states and 2019 Lok Sabha elections. BJP's two-day national executive concludes with a political resolution on New India. BJP slams violence reported in several parts across the country as Rahul Gandhi leads a Bharat Bandh over hike in fuel prices. 20 opposition parties take part. Rail road traffic hit in Bihar. Schools and colleges in Bengaluru and Odisha closed. Rupee touches 72.66 against the US dollar, falls 75 paise in early morning trade. Strong demand for American currency and buying by oil refiners weighs on the domestic currency. Quantum of punishment to be decided against two Indian Mujahideen convicts in Hyderabad, the twin blast case today. Explosions at an eatery and a theatre in Hyderabad in 2007 had killed 44 people. And Novak Djokovic wins a third US Open title, beats Juan Martin Del Potro in three sets, equals Pete Sampras on 14 Grand Slams. The biggest story developing at the top of one, Congress is leading a day-long nationwide protest against the fuel price rise and other issues today. Rail and road traffic is hit across Bihar due to protests, and hundreds of protesters took to the streets since early morning in different parts of Bihar. Over a dozen long route trains were halted at Patna, Gaya, Bhojpur, Jehanabad, Bhagalpur and Muzaffarpur railway stations. Meanwhile, bus services were affected since early morning in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Many private education institutions also remained closed. Meanwhile, the Maharashtra Congress today staged protests in various parts of the state in response to the Bharat Bandh called by the party's central leadership against rising fuel prices. And as a precautionary measure, the Karnataka government declared a public holiday for schools and colleges in Bengaluru. Public bus service is also not operational today in the state capital. In Odisha, protesters blocked a train at Sambalpur while protesting along with the opposition parties in the morning. Schools are also closed today due to the protests. Almost 20 other political parties, including the DMK, SP, NCP, RJD, JDS and the left parties, have extended their support. Trinamool Congress, however, has not joined the nationwide protest. Congress began the protest from Rajghat in Delhi, attended by several leaders, including Rahul Gandhi and former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh.
Today, on this stage, the entire Vipakshi Dal is sitting here together. And this is a reflection. विचारधारा एक है और हम एक साथ मिलकर सब एक साथ मिलकर बीजेपी को हराने जा रहे हैं।
सरकार बहुत कुछ कर चुकी है जो देश के हित में नहीं था, अब ये हद से भी पार कर गई है और इस सरकार को अब बदलने का मौका आने ही वाला है। जहां तक हिंदुस्तान की जनता का सवाल है, हर तरफ से पुकारें आ रही हैं, शोर आ रहा है, किसान परेशान है, छोटे व्यापारी परेशान है, नौजवान परेशान है, उनको कोई रोजगार के साधन नजर आ नहीं रहे।
And the BJP meanwhile has hit out at the Congress for leading the nationwide bund. The BJP has blamed Congress for violence in several areas as the Bandh is not finding much support from the common people.
The BJP strongly believes that in spite of some momentary difficulty, the people are not supporting this band. And that is unnerving the Congress party and the opposition. And the resort to violence is designed to overawe the people of India. Khauf ka mahol banaya ja raha hai. जब जनता का समर्थन नहीं मिलता तो उग्रता का प्रदर्शन कर बंद को सफल करने की कोशिश की जा रही है.
And even as the opposition parties call for a Bharat Band to protest against the fuel prices hike, the state-owned oil marketing companies today increased the price of petrol and diesel in the country. The price of petrol and diesel touched a new high, with Mumbai paying the maximum among the four metros. In Mumbai, petrol cost 88.12 rupees a litre and diesel is priced at 77.32 rupees a litre. And in Delhi, the petrol price has been risen to a record 80.73 rupees a litre, while diesel price has been increased to 72.83 rupees a litre. The petrol prices have gone up by around 5% since 1st of August, while the diesel prices have gone up by 7% during the same period. The fuel prices are likely to go up further as the rupee today hit another all-time low of around rupees 72 against the US dollar. While the price of Brent oil was still hovering around $77 a barrel. The rupee weakened further today to hit a fresh low of 72.6 against the dollar. The rupee fell over 75 paise in the late morning deals due to the rising crude oil prices, strengthening the dollar and a widened current account deficit. The domestic currency opened at a record low of 72.15 a dollar from its previous close of 71.73. It breached its previous record low of 72.11 that it had hit on 6th of September. Meanwhile, the markets also opened in red today amid negative Asian cues. BSE Sensex dropped 171.79 points or 0.45% to trade at 38,218.03, and the Nifty too was trading at 11,539.75, down 49.35 points or 0.43%. On to some other news now. Outlining its campaign theme for the 2019 general elections, the BJP's two-day national executive concluded on Sunday. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed the final day of the BJP's national executive, giving the party a new slogan for the upcoming polls in four states and the 2019 Lok Sabha elections, namely, Ajay Bharat Atal BJP, that is, Invincible India, Steadfast BJP. The national executive concluded with a political resolution on New India that praised the government's achievements under Prime Minister Narendra Modi as much as it slammed the opposition for its lack of leadership, policy and strategy. The BJP's resolution said that the opposition was running a Stop Modi campaign while the government was committed to a New India free of poverty, corruption, casteism, terrorism and communalism by 2022. Insisting that the opposition was only daydreaming and looking for alternatives, the party said that it will get more votes and seats in 2019 than in past elections. And party chief Amit Shah claimed a reign of 50 years for the party if it pulls off a victory in 2019.
Today, Modi ji gave a clarion call to recall two powerful phrases: Ajay Bharat, Atal Bhajpa. An India which is unconquerable, which is not to be subjugated by anyone. And a BJP which remains firmly committed to its principles. जो अध्यक्ष जी ने कुछ महत्वपूर्ण बात कही है, उसमें उन्होंने ये कहा है कि 22 करोड़ परिवारों से हमें संपर्क करना है. और इसके साथ उन्होंने दूसरी महत्वपूर्ण बात कही कि हमारे 9 करोड़ कार्यकर्ताओं का कॉर्पस हमारे पास है. एक बात अध्यक्ष जी ने और कही कि 14 के बाद हमने जरा भी विश्राम नहीं किया, चाहे वो हमारे प्रधानमंत्री हों, हमारे राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष हों उन्होंने एक बात कही कि प्रधानमंत्री बनने के बाद माननीय मोदी जी ने देश के 300 लोकसभा को विजिट किया है। वो 300 कर लिया, जो बचे हुए हैं उसको भी कर लेंगे चुनाव के पहले। तो जहां हमारे प्रधानमंत्री इतनी मेहनत करते हैं और हमने देश के लिए इतना काम किया है, तो 19 हम जीतेंगे और 19 के जीतने के बाद 50 साल तक हमें हटाने वाला कोई नहीं है। और ये उन्होंने कहा, हम कोई अहंकार में नहीं बोल रहे हैं, अपने काम के आधार पर बोल रहे हैं। और ये देश की पॉलिटिक्स बदल रही है, देश परफॉर्मेंस और होप की ओर जा रहा है।
उसमें मूल मुद्दा यह है कि एक नए भारत का संकल्प प्रधानमंत्री जी ने किया और 4 साल के बाद हम ये कह सकते हैं कि नए भारत का संकल्प साकार करने की दिशा में भारत ने बहुत तरक्की की है, समाज ने भी साथ दिया है और इसलिए पूरा विश्वास इस प्रस्ताव में जताया है कि नया भारत साकार होके ही रहेगा। और कैसा है नया भारत? गरीबी से मुक्त, भ्रष्टाचार से मुक्त, आतंकवाद से मुक्त, जातिवाद से मुक्त, संप्रदायवाद से मुक्त, ऐसा एक नया भारत 2022 तक स्थापित होगा, इसका आज विश्वास इस प्रस्ताव में प्रमुखता से किया गया है।
On to some other news, the Vice President of India, M. Venkaiah Naidu, attended the concluding session of the World Hindu Congress held to commemorate 125 years of Swami Vivekananda's Chicago speech and said that Swami Vivekananda's messages reverberate across India and are relevant still today.
Addressing the second edition of World Hindu Congress on the occasion of the 125 years of Swami Vivekananda's address at the World Parliament of Religions, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu said that the World's Parliament of Religions emerged as a celebration of the rich diversity in religions and cultural beliefs around the world.
It brought the world together to understand different world views. It deepened our appreciation of the common quest for peace, harmony that human beings have been engaged in from time immemorial. Swami Vivekananda's address at this parliament has been incredibly influential.
Vice President said that the extraordinary vision of ancient India encapsulates a message that is timeless and eternally relevant because it is holistic, integrated and universal. Stressing on the uniqueness of India, he said that whenever the world is faced with the threats of fragmentation, conflict, hatred and irrational prejudices, the Indian voice brings to the world the soothing, inclusive perspectives that have pervaded its cultural world for more than 2 millennia.
Spiritual wellsprings that have sustained the world over many centuries. We in India feel proud that such a voice that stirred the hearts of minds of delegates in the conference 125 years ago still reverberates and strikes a deep resonance in many people across the globe. It does so, in my view, because of the extraordinary vision of ancient India that encapsulates a message that seems timeless.
Vice President said that the messages of tolerance, acceptance, unity and plurality, of love, compassion, service, charity, gender equality, poverty alleviation and protection of the environment that exponents like Swami Vivekananda have spread across the world embody timeless values that are more relevant today than ever before. We should ensure that these values are further reinforced through behavior and action.
Sustainable development without peace. If there is a tension, there cannot be attention. Progress cannot be reached without peace. So peace and progress, they go together. So we must always take peaceful methods and then treat every human being as our brethren and also treat every creature as our own. India is also moving an ambitious reform agenda that seeks to transform people's lives. At this juncture, the values we all cherish as Indians can be the guide spots posts of our individual growth and collective advancement.
saying that India is also moving on an ambitious reform agenda that seeks to transform people's lives. Vice President said that at this juncture, the values we all cherish as Indians can be the guidepost for our individual growth and collective enhancement. The second edition of the World Hindu Congress attracted delegates, participants from across the world. Members from Suriname, Fiji, Mauritius, Thailand, and members of several voluntary organizations also attended the event.
Vice President said that Swami Vivekananda's address at the World Parliament of Religions still reverberates in India. He said that Indians are proud and the impact of that speech is still resonating in India. With camera person Dushmanta from Chicago, Rajkamal Rao, Rajya Sabha TV.
And on the sidelines of the World Hindu Congress, Vice President Naidu met with the Vice President of Suriname, Ashwin Adhin, and both the leaders discussed on matters relating to mutual cooperation, trade and investment. And during the discussion, Vice President Naidu told his Surinamese counterpart that India appreciates the pluralistic, peaceful and diverse cultural heritage of his country. Both the leaders also discussed deep historical and cultural ties that go back to over 145 years and hope to further deepening of the bilateral relations. And in Midday News, we'll take a very short break here. We'll be right back with more news.
Enter the majestic forecourt of Rashtrapati Bhavan and you'll come across the Jaipur Column. A gift to the Viceroy from Sawai Madho Singh, the Maharaja of Jaipur, to commemorate the creation of the new capital. The 145-meter high column is crowned with six pointed crystal stars on a bronze lotus, and inside the stone shaft runs a steel tube which weighs a little more than 5 tons. The base of the column has text conceived by Lord Irwin and Sir Edwin Lutyens inscribed on it.
Welcome back after the break. The Enforcement Directorate moved Delhi court seeking to cancel the interim relief from arrest granted to Karthi Chidambaram in the Airtel Max's money laundering case. The special CBI judge agreed to hear the plea after the probe agency told the court that custodial interrogation of a former union minister P. Chidambaram's son, Karthi Chidambaram, was required in the matter. Earlier on 7th of August, the Delhi court had extended the interim protection from arrest granted to senior Congress leader P. Chidambaram and his son Karthi till 8th of October. And on to the other big story today. A special court in Hyderabad, which had convicted two Indian Mujahideen operatives last week for the 2007 bomb blast at Lumbini Park and Gokul Chat, will pronounce the quantum of punishment today. The convicts were pronounced guilty by the court judge on 4th of September. Two other accused were acquitted for the want of enough evidence. All the four jailed from convicted are from Maharashtra and have been involved in other cases in Pune and Mumbai. Three others are absconding and are believed to be in Pakistan. The quantum of punishment is also the judgment on the fifth accused, namely Tariq Anjum, who is accused of harboring the perpetrators in New Delhi and in other places, will also be pronounced today. On the evening of 25th of August 2007, 32 people died in the blast at Gokul Chat in Hyderabad and 12 were killed during a laser show at Lumbini Park opposite Secretariat in Hyderabad. 68 people were injured in the twin blasts. News from the south of the country, the Tamil Nadu cabinet has recommended the release of all seven life convicts in the assassination of former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi. The recommendations were sent to the state governor after a resolution to this effect was adopted by the cabinet under the leadership of Chief Minister K. Palaniswamy. The move comes days after the Supreme Court asked the Tamil Nadu governor to consider the mercy petition of one of the life convicts, Pirari Valan, who is seeking pardon in the case. The DMK has welcomed the recommendation. However, its ally, the Congress Party, has rejected it, saying that it will set a wrong precedent. Former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated on 21st of May 1991 at Sri Perumbudur by an LTTE woman suicide bomber at an election rally. 14 others, including the suicide bomber, were also killed. This is the second time that the state cabinet has decided to release all the seven convicts. In 2014, a former chief minister of the state, Jay Jalalitha, had urged the centre to release them, but the centre had been opposed to the decision. And starting today, Delhiites will get a doorstep delivery of 40 government services. The Delhi government will provide 40 services at the doorsteps of people in the first phase at an extra fee of just 50 rupees. Various certificates such as caste, new water connection, a driving license, a ration card, domicile, marriage registration, duplicate RC and the change of address in RC, among others, will be covered under the scheme. Delhi government had proposed the doorstep delivery of services earlier this year. Let's now get you all the international news. First up, news from Afghanistan, where insurgents killed at least 29 security forces in separate attacks through the country, as many mark the 17th anniversary of the killing of a prominent anti-Taliban leader. The deadliest attack was in northern Baghlan province, where the militants overran an army base after a long siege and sustained clashes. The attackers killed more than 20 people here. There was also protracted gunfire in Kabul by masked men riding in convoys of motorcycles and vehicles with tinted windows, leaving at least 13 people wounded. It was passed off for the annual commemoration of the death anniversary of Ahmad Shah Massoud, a top anti-Taliban leader who was slain 17 years ago by suspected Al-Qaeda operatives. Meanwhile, also in capital Kabul, a suicide bomber on a motorbike blew himself up near a convoy of gunmen, killing at least 7 people. Islamic State claimed responsibility for this attack. At least 7 people were killed and 25 wounded in this explosion. News from Paris now, where 7 people have been injured in an attack by a man armed with a knife and an iron bar in the French capital. The man, who is said to be an Afghan national, was later arrested. The attack took place on the banks of a canal in the northeast of the French capital. Of the 7 people wounded, 4 are in a critical condition. The incident took place just after 11 p.m. on Sunday on the banks of a canal. The man, armed with a knife and an iron bar, attacked people, initially stabbing 2 people near a cinema along the Aurec Canal. And several people then threw balls at the attacker to try to stop him. The man was hit and he later fled. He then reportedly attacked 2 more people in the city. All the sporting action now. England will resume its overnight score of 114 runs on day 4 of the 5th and the final test match. On day 3, Alistair Cook displayed his brilliance to power England to a strong position. Cook was unbeaten on 46 in his last international innings, as England reached 114 for the loss of 2 wickets on day 3 at the Oval. The English skipper Joe Root was unbeaten on 29, and at the end of the play, Joe Root and Cook together put up a 52 runs partnership for the 3rd wicket to extend their lead to 154 runs in their 2nd innings. Earlier, Ravindra Jadeja scored 86 not out for India as the team finished their 1st innings at 292. And triple jumper Arpinder Singh created history by becoming the first Indian to win a medal in the IAAF Continental Cup as he clinched the bronze medal in the competition. Arpinder, who had won a gold in the Asian Games, cleared 16.59 metres in the first of his 3 jumps to be in the 4-man semi-finals. And in his next attempt, Arpinder could only manage a 16.33 metres jump to miss out on the 2-man final. But he managed to claim the bronze medal. No Indian has ever won a medal in the Continental Cup, which was known as the IAAF World Cup, before 2010. And with the win, Arpinder became the first Indian to clinch a medal in this competition. News from the US Open, where Novak Djokovic clinched his third US Open title on Sunday. Djokovic claimed a 6-3, 7-6, 6-3 triumph over Juan Martin Del Potro, taking him level with Pete Sampras's mark of 14 Grand Slam titles. Djokovic, already in the champion in 2011 and in 2015, is now just 3 slams behind Rafael Nadal and 6 back from the record 20 held by Roger Federer. It was also the third time that the 31-year-old Serb, who missed last year's tournament due to an elbow injury, completed the Wimbledon US Open double. For world number 3, Del Potro, it was a heartbreaking experience coming in just as a second slam final, 9 years after he was crowned the US Open champion. And with that, we wrap up this edition of Midday News. News and updates continue on your channel. Thanks for watching.